Hi everyone, and I hope that everyone is liking the videos which I'm posting about the TypeScript. So we are in the final phase. We will be just finishing this particular course. We just need to cover few more things on the type generic. So let's talk about that. So merge property. Here we will talk about the example of object.assign. I have two generic types, T and U. And this is my function where I'm accepting object one of type T and object two of type U. And what it can return either T or it can return either U, right? So this is what it is. Here I will be doing object.assign. Object.assign here it will return the object from obj1 and obj2. Obj1 and obj2, what it is saying, okay, can't find name obj1. Okay, it was capital object. Right, this is a basic example of generic. Right, generics can be optional also, like optional argument we keep passing since the beginning. So this is of type T generic, and here P1 can be optional of type T, and this function is returning void. We are fine with that. It is not returning anything. Control.logP. Right. Next thing is we can call this function by just passing empty. This will also work. P1 is an optional, right? It cannot find, okay, it is shows. Then you can just pass an object. You can pass whatever you want. You can pass a string. You can pass some object. Everything will be valid, right? Now let's talk about generics with union. So let's create an interface object with man or anything. Like here I will be specifying some parameter like kind is object with age, and second parameter is age, which is of type number. Always it gives me null. Okay, now I'm creating another function, function where the generic is extending object, this object with, let's put as age or something, object with age, or there is object with age can be an array, and can be either T, or there is a P parameter of type T and it is returning type T. Now if you try to read it, so what it is saying, it is a generic which is extending object with age or object with age of type array. Okay, so here I'm passing some argument of type T and it's returning the same parameter type T, right? So here it's like you are passing the so P we are passing in this function is instance of array. If P is instance of array, means you are getting object with age in an array. So in this case, we can return P of 0. Otherwise, you can return P itself, right? This is a very good example of understanding the TypeScript generics, right? Object with age of array or object with age. So this is here I'm type using union type. It can be either of single array or it can be either. Now, then the next thing we will talk about the key of another important aspect, very important, I will say, because this is also being used extensively. So like, let's create interface man. An interface man is having the name as a string, okay. Birth date is of type date. and is happy. Oh, and Boolean. Okay, we are checking the happiness of that human. Okay, now, so I'm creating a new const. Type is homo sapiens of type man. Okay, and I'm defining the properties. It is an error. Okay, yeah, it's empty right now. So I need to have a name as a property, which should be TKS. But date, it can be a new date. And pass your new date. This is your date. And then is happy is another property. Which is of type Boolean. Okay, we created this now. Now let's create a function which will be extending. So we will write, it's time to use this both the object. So I created a function show human, and it is passing object of type main. Okay, object of type main and field of type string. Now my case is I actually wanted to get the value of one of the property from the man, right? Here right now what I will do, object, and I will pass the field. But how will I make sure that object field is actually being passed, which is from this list? Okay, what happens here? Function show human, object is of type man, field is of type string, and it is not returning anything. We console.log, what is happening? I forgot it. Okay, now I can access it, right? But how can I make sure that field should be from this list? Field can be anything. I will be just calling this function. Okay, I will be calling this function. I will be passing the homo as a type. Okay, because we already have that, and field I can be passing any blah blah, right? But it will be accepting it because we are passing that as a string. It will not be breaking in this case, but we can take care of this. Like, I will override this function and I will create another function show human one, and where I will say object is of type man, and field will be key of man, right? Now what I'm restricting is, okay, first argument is object man, I'm fine with that. Okay, second argument should be a field which should be key of man. I mean, this must be a property of man interface only. So human one, I am passing homo as a first property, comma, and if I try to put blah blah, then it will give me error, right? Because it should be of one of those types. So I will be passing either name is fine. You can pass birth date, that is also fine. You can pass age happy, that is also fine. But when you try to type something else, it will break, right? Because you're violating. Now field should be of key of man. Whatever the key you are passing, that should be a property of man. And it is doing a lot of restriction. When we have these kind of scenario, we should use the key of. Okay, this is the last video of this particular series where we covered the key of extending the interface. Okay, generics with the union, extending the generics, right? And a lot many more. Okay, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching.